This edition of the Ridley Report is brought to you by MineThings.com.
A lot of people, they look on YouTube and they see all the activities that's going on in New Hampshire. And it wasn't always so. New Hampshire was not always the hotbed of activity. It really took a lot of individuals to make it be the hotbed of activity. And one of the things that I think that we tend to forget, we always look at people and we say, I wish I could do something like the Ridley Report.
Me? Oh, yuck.
I wish I could run for State House. I wish I could volunteer for Ron Paul. I wish I could go be ambassador for the Free State Project. And I always tend to laugh at people and say, you can. There's nothing stopping you from being the next great activist. And that's what I think is appealing about New Hampshire, is because we do get people who move here, and they're people who are never, ever active before. A lot of people, when they ask me, they're like, so, how long have you been involved in the Liberty Movement? And I'm like, about a month after I moved to New Hampshire is when I started. And people never believe me, is I literally did nothing before I moved to New Hampshire as a Liberty activist. I truly did nothing. And I think it's the culture of the other activists that we feed off of, sometimes for good and sometimes for bad, to be blunt. Sometimes we feed off each other poorly. I'm honest, I'm a realist. And I think that when we talk about what people can do here in New Hampshire, I'm gonna tell you it's something you could start helping the Free State Project before you get to New Hampshire. And that's the key, is the future of the Free State Project. I'm not gonna let Carla's secret, she's like, don't give away my speech. Like, I wrote it, I can say it. So I think that's the important part, is to think about the future of the Free State Project is what we want to make of it, right? And that's the key. And Carla, I don't think, maybe she used to be a statist, but when she was living in New York, is it fair to say you weren't really an activist? So, you know, Louis, it's kind of funny, is when I met Louis for the first time, I was at a picnic bench about 2 in the morning up on the hill a couple years ago, and I told the FSPIT guy, I'm like, hey, I found another computer geek, let's put him to work. And now he's the head of the FSPIT. So I should say internet, like, you know, information technology. But that's the thing, is a lot of people always say, what can I contribute? Whatever skills you have, trust me, we can put them to use. If you have absolutely no skills whatsoever, give me your email address, I can put you to use. I have chickens to feed in my backyard. I got all sorts of chores you can do. You need no skill for that. So that's the thing to think about. When you hear Carla talk about the future, I want you to envision what you can do to make Carla's future the reality. So please welcome President of the FSP, Carla.
You know what I'm realizing is my last name is so hard to say that people are just, I'm gonna become like Madonna. People are gonna be like, Carla, because no one knows how to say it. Strangely here, everyone has an opinion. And I would like to know yours. So we're gonna get to that in a little bit up here at the mic. So, you know, start letting the brain cells cook and run through some ideas. Before we can talk about the future, we have to talk a little bit about the past. And I'm glad that Chris pointed out that it was 2006, the first time that we came to Porkfest. And we came from New York City. And in 2006, I would describe Porkfest the following way. There were about 100, maybe 120 people. There were exactly 10 women. Of those 120 people, there were a lot of mountain men. I know them all now, but you know what? If you're coming from the city and you walk into a room and there are 100 guys carrying guns with like Unabomber beards, it's a little intimidating. And I think it's a testament to the community we're building that it's 6 years later, we have a sea of people in a range of every color, lots of girls. I mean, we're actually, you know how I know we're winning the revolution? The chicks. We came in on Sunday night and a car pulled up next to me and like four really hot girls got out of the car and I was like, we're so gonna win this revolution. Because that's what you need. You need that balance, and we need that balance in everything and in our own lives as well. What? Blind them with boobs, TM. So also with the growth of Porkfest, you can actually see it in what is going on around us right now. I mean, every single one of you that are sitting here is living in history. We started, 10 years ago. We know this is an idea that's working because we're the pioneers of the future, and we've made a decision to all stand together and to say that this is a message of truth, and it's something that we believe in. And you know what? We're not utopian because we are here. We are choosing and we're making a choice to actually up our lives and move to a place and stand together. And that is hugely, hugely unique. And every one of you is a pioneer in history.
Have you played your fill of pro-government video games? MineThings.com could be the solution. It's free, imaginative, and you can play it entirely in your web browser. Recolonize the smothered earth. Dig up cool artifacts. Compete with other players in a free market scramble. Just remember to use the coupon code RIDLEY. That gives you twice the mining rate. MineThings.com